Why are you all so serious? Is it because of fasting? You know how you look? Come on, give a smile, man. The word of God has to be learned with joy, with smile, with entertainment. Praise God. Hallelujah. 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 Am I giving you good news or a bad news? Yes. Then why are you so? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, the word that comes out of your mouth is a container that contains spiritual substance. And this container that has come out, you must hear it inside out. So God said, let there be light, and there was light. So when was light? After God spoke or before God spoke? Now, when do we say we are healed? Before we get the healing or after we get the healing? And what did God do? He spoke first what he believed, and then it happened. We will say, let it happen, then I will believe it has happened. Are you understanding the difference? First you believe in your heart, first you believe in your mind, and what you believe, so shall it be. Praise God. Yeah, the Bibles have come. God bless you, brother. Give them. How many of you want a Bible? Those who don't have. Now nobody will even lift your hand. Can you take it? Anybody else? And you don't have to return it, okay? God bless you. It's coming, it's coming. Hallelujah. God is truly our provider. Amen. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, we distribute Bibles in thousands. Because we know the value of it. Only when you value it, then there will be an action. If you don't value it, there will never be a corresponding action. Praise God. Hallelujah. Okay, let's come back. God said, let there be light, and there was light. So there was light came only after God spoke. Yeah, just give them. Anybody else? Give that brother in red. Anybody else? There's one remaining. You got a Bible with you, brother? Okay. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What a great day for us to bless you with a Bible. You know, now I've given 10 Bibles. You know what I'm believing for? 1,000 to come into my account. That's why we are all the time looking out for opportunities to sow. Because the Bible says, what you sow, so shall you reap. And that's how it works for us. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So God said, let there be light, and there was light. And God saw that the light was good. Now how did it happen? First God spoke and he saw what he wanted to see. And then it happened. In the same way, you and I got to see first and then it will happen. Let's take some examples from the Bible. Let's go to Genesis chapter 15. We will take the same formula and we'll see. Are you there? Hello, are you ready?
Yes.
Here we go. After these things, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision, saying, fear not, Abram, I am your shield and your exceeding great reward. And Abram said, Lord God, what will you give me? See, I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus. And Abram said, behold, to me you have given no seed. And see, one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, This shall not be your heir, but he that shall come forth out of your own bowels shall be your heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, Look now towards heaven and talk, tell the stars, if you be able to number them. And he said to them, So shall your seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it to him for righteousness. Praise God. When you read this passage, it's so interesting that Abraham said to God, See, I am childless and I have no child. And see, I am planned to adopt a son, a child. His name is Eliezer of Damascus. And God said to him, No, that's not going to be a child. You will have your own. And then God brought him out of the tent and told him, Look at the stars and tell the stars and count the stars. And if you are able to count them, so shall your descendants be. Praise God. Now let's say there is a childless couple who come to you. And they are married 10 years and they have no children. What will you say? You will tell the husband, Listen husband, you got to go to the terrace every night and start counting stars. You will get children. Praise God. What a solution God gives Abraham and that poor man, old man. Counting stars every night. Where is Abraham? Every night. Counting stars. And he will get a child. Why do you think God gives him that work every night? Is it easy, brother? I'm talking to the men. Is it easy, brother? If God has to tell you, count the stars and you'll get a child. Every night, husband is sweating. He's saying, nearly over, and there comes sunlight and the stars have disappeared. The next night he has to count all over again. The Bible says Abraham believed. That means every night he was doing what? Why do you think God told him to count the stars? Obviously, Abraham had no work. Huh? Listen. Again, let's go to the topic of faith again. What was Abraham's imagination? What was Abraham's hope? His imagination and his hope was Eliezer of Damascus, whom he's going to adopt. Right? So Abraham's hope is Eliezer. God's hope is Isaac. Are they agreeing with one another? Hello? No. So can God perform a miracle? No. And that is why God has to destroy the imagination or the thought or a dream or a desire of Eliezer, which is in the mind of Abraham. And that is why he tells him, Listen, Abraham, can you see those stars? I want you to count them. And before he can say, count the stars, God had to bring him out of the tent. You know what's the meaning of out of the tent? Most of us are sleeping in a tent. When you open your eyes, when you are in your bedroom and you open your eyes, what can you see? The roof, the ceiling. That's all you can see. You can't see beyond that. And that's exactly what the devil does in our life. He stops our imagination. The most powerful gift that God has given us is imagination. If you can develop your imagination on the base, on the word of God, and open your mouth and speak it out, that word, carrying that image which is in your mind, according to the word of God, can bring impossible things in your life. Hallelujah. And that is why God has to destroy the image of Eliezer which is in his mind and replace it with his own descendants. Now when Abraham is doing it over and over again every night, what's happening? He can no longer see now stars. He can see the faces of his descendants in his imagination. So before he can get a child, he has to change his thinking. Before the word of God can operate in your life, you must change your thinking. Did you get that? God does three things. The first thing, he showed him the stars. Second thing he does is he shows him the sand. And he says, Listen, just as this dust or the sand that you see, so shall your descendants be. Now imagine for you all are from Chennai. You must have surely gone to the seashore. And when you wear a footwear and you go to the seashore, does the sand enter the footwear? Yes. Now if the sand has entered your footwear, does it irritate you? The same happened to Abraham. Every day when he's walking in the desert, the sand enters his footwear and the sand is irritating him. But in that irritation, he is remembering the promise of God. So the sand is reminding him of the promise of God during the day. The star is reminding him of the promise of God during the night. Now these two things are done. There is one more thing that God has to deal. He calls himself Abram. And God has to change his name and call him Abraham. Abraham means father of many nations. So when Abraham is 99 years old, he has to go and reintroduce himself as Abraham. I want you to imagine, now let's say I'm Abraham, I'm 99 years old. And you are the people, and I go and tell you, you know my name has been changed, I'm Abraham. Which means father of many nations. You know what people will say? First get one child, then talk about father of many nations. All your life you tried and you did not get one. And he's saying, I'm a father of many nations. But what does he do? He names himself Abraham. And the name of Sarah has been changed. Her name was Sarai. And she has been changed into Sarah. That you will get in Genesis 17. When you read Genesis 17, you will get the name being changed. Sarah means mother of many nations. Imagine for Sarah, all her life, she has been barren. And now she has to call herself, I'm Sarah. People will say, listen, old woman, 89 years old, thinking that you can get a child now. But what does she do? She prepares her imagination. Abraham is imagining father of many nations. Sarah is imagining mother of many nations. And they are calling themselves by that name. And when people say Abraham, he turns behind. Okay, let me put it this way. Are you all sitting on a sofa or on a chair? Why not a sofa? Why do you call it a chair? Why don't you call it a table? When you call it a chair, there is a character which is in that name. So when you say a chair, you know the character of that thing. Hello? You don't look at a cat and you call it a lion. When you say a lion, you know the nature and the character in that name. You don't call a rat an elephant. Are you understanding? So every name has a nature, it has a character. In the same way, when Abraham is calling his name Abraham, he is saying, I got that nature. I am so powerful that I have a nation in my bowels, in my loins, before it is manifested. That's called faith. Faith is not what the evidence that you have. Faith is the spiritual evidence that you have. And that comes through the word. Did you get that? Hello, did you get that? Now ask a question. What kind of images do you make every day? Do you make images based on God's word, or do you make images based on your situations and circumstances and your nature and character and your problems? Which one? Come on, which one? And then you are praying the whole day, you are struggling, you are suffering, you are in pain, and you're wondering, why is it not happening? It's not going to happen till you change your thinking. Amen? Hello, amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Change your thinking. Change your thinking. Praise God. Did Abraham get a son after that? Oh yeah. Was it easy? Not at all. See, when you read the Bible, you say, oh, God blessed him with a son. No. God blessed him with a son, a promise. But Abraham had to do what? Believe in that promise. The Bible says he believed. That means every night he was counting stars, literally, physically counting stars. Are you understanding? In the same way, for you to see the promise of God being manifested, you must take that promise, believe that promise, and act on it day and night. And then you will see it manifest. Let's take another example of the word of God. Okay. This is about a woman with the issue of blood. The Bible says there was a woman who had a problem for 12 years. And she had a problem with the issue of blood. She went to all the doctors. She spent the money. But her condition grew worse. One day she heard about Jesus. And she said to herself, if I just go and touch his garment, I shall be healed. And she went to the midst of the crowd, touched his garment, and she was completely healed. Now question, how did this woman get healed? The next time you say faith, you must also give me the document that you are talking about. How did this woman get healed? Let me give you some points that will help you. If a woman has got an issue of blood for, say, 2 months, will she be able to stand? No. And this woman had issue of blood only for 12 years. So she will definitely stand. Did she go to the doctor? Yeah. Did she spend her money? Yeah. Did her condition become good? It became worse. That means she can definitely walk, right? Third thing, this woman, because she has got a bleeding problem, according to the law, she cannot touch anybody and nobody can touch her. The moment she touches somebody, that person becomes unclean and she can be stoned to death. Praise God. Now it is easy for her because nobody will come close to her, right? She'll be stoned to death. Fourth thing, the Bible says she had a Mercedes car. So she got into the car and honked, and the crowd got all around, and Jesus was all by himself, and she took Jesus in the car and touched him, and she was healed. In those days there were cars. That means she has to walk all that distance. Praise the Lord. And as you know, Jesus was like a parish priest in one place. Praise God. Every fourth Saturday you will get Father Josiah. Every fourth Sunday you will get Father Josiah, because he's fixed. But what about Jesus? One day is on the mountain, the second day is by the sea, the third day is gone somewhere, fourth day is in Galilee, fifth day is somewhere else. So she has to find his address and go and find him. Praise God. In Chennai, there are local trains. Gardi Rida? Okay. Have you ever traveled in the local train of Chennai during the peak hours? I know about Bombay. In Bombay, if you want to travel in the train, you just have to go and stand there. You don't have to bother. The crowd will take you in and the crowd will bring you out. Hallelujah. And once you are in and you want to go out and you tell that person, I want to go out, you really have to struggle. Praise God. And this woman was a superwoman. So she had to pass through the crowd. She had to pass through the... How do you think she passed through the crowd? Stanley, come here. Praise God. I want a strong woman. Can I see a strong woman? Stanley, who do you think is a strong woman here? This lady in blue? Okay, sister, come here. A strong woman, come here. I thought this girl also looks to be strong. Don't you think she's strong? Yeah. Come here. We will give you the second choice, okay? First choice. Stand behind me, us. Now let's take, for example, she is the woman with the issue of blood. And that's Jesus in the white. Okay? And we are the crowd. We are the crowd. Okay? You have to pass through us, not pass around us. Pass through us. Come on, let's go. Let's give a try. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah. I told you, she's not strong. She did not even try. Come on, try. Try. I think your daughter can do better than you. Daughter, come here. Just try. What, mama is not even trying. Look at the daughter. I think the youth are much stronger than the elders. Look at the youth. There. Oh, there. Come on. You have to pass through, baby. Not push us apart. Pass through. Try, no. Okay, now look at the strong woman. Come. Come. I know she can push through. Be careful. She's very strong. Don't look at her face. Don't go by her appearance. In her heart, she has already prepared herself. She might go with a jerk. Get ready. I told you, Stanley, she's strong. Oh my God. Now she's pinching, man. Praise God. No. I purposely demonstrated to you. Just hold on. Now, this sister is trying her best to get through two of us. And the Bible says the woman got through the crowd. Crowd. And let me tell you, every person who came there, they came for their own healing. None of them will allow this woman to pass through. What was the secret that this woman could pass through? The Bible says she passed through the crowd. What's the secret? Oh yeah, come here, come. Let's see how strong she is. Now she has an urge to go and touch you, brother. Urge, the desire, that all that. Let's see. Come. Urge. She has got an urge to touch. Yeah, go ahead. Now she has come with all her willpower. No, before you do that, tie your sari and all that tight. Yeah, come on. Yes, yeah, come. You know, when you go to Bombay, when the train is in the platform, all these ladies will tuck their saris and get ready. Before the train can stop, it's full. Now, get ready. She has come with all her urge. Right. Stanley, don't put me to shame.
Okay.
Come on, go ahead. Yeah, pass through. Yeah. Oh my God. There. I told you she has got urge, brother. She has got a strong willpower. Oh my God. Okay, you don't want me to hold my hand? Okay, don't hold my hand, brother. Come on. Come on. No. Hello. Why I'm saying is, please understand, the woman had bleeding problem for 12 years. How can she pass through the crowd? Aha, crawl. You are from Chennai? Good. Tomorrow morning, we will take you to the railway station here. And when the train is coming, you crawl to and try to get in. No, you crawl. You just do that. People will stamp you to death. Don't even think crawling. Are you a Swami? Swamini? Hallelujah. Is it possible? No. Now, I'll give you the formula. Please stand here. The Bible says she heard about. If she heard about Jesus, that means somebody came and spoke. Somebody came and what? Word. Spoke what? Word. And word about whom? So somebody came and gave a spiritual container having the substance called Jesus. The person spoke and went. What did this woman do? What she heard, she kept speaking. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. And all the time she's speaking. What's happening? Life is flowing. She gets up from a place and she keeps on speaking. Just as God spoke the word and the Holy Spirit brought light, in the same way, when you speak the word, the Holy Spirit will take the same word and bring forth manifestation. Now here is where she comes. Just stand here. Now when she is here and she cannot pass through, she has not stopped saying, oh my God, the crowd is so big, how will I enter? She is not even bothered about the crowd. She is still continuing to say, if I just touch his garment, I shall be healed. I will touch his garment, I shall be healed. I'll touch his garment, I shall be healed. Now she is releasing what? Spiritual container. Now what is the Holy Spirit's job? To take that word and make a place for her to pass through. So what will the Holy Spirit do? The Holy Spirit will take control over us. I might turn this side, he will turn that side, and she will pass through. What's the meaning? Yeah, good. Good. Come here. What's the meaning? The words of faith that I speak today will destroy the walls of tomorrow that the devil has raised up against me. But the very words of fear and worry that I speak will raise up the walls of destruction in my life tomorrow. So what is the word doing? The word is bringing life. Praise the Lord. Did you understand? Which one is better? Hello, which one is better? Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Come on. Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Can you see the power in the word? Did you ever believe that, baby, that the Bible is the flesh of Jesus? Might be you are thinking that's only a storybook. Oh no, it's Jesus himself. And that you can touch only by faith. Praise God. Let's close our eyes and let's talk to Jesus. You heard the power in the word. Let's talk to him. And let's thank him for making us understand that every word that has come out of our mouth has got power. First of all, let's repent for the times when we kept on speaking about our problems. The negative words that we spoke against ourselves, against our family, against our loved ones, against those who hurt us. And the devil used somebody to make you repeat and speak his word. So tell the Lord, Lord Jesus, I ask you, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you, destroy every negative word that I've ever spoken. Lord, let the power of those negative words be completely destroyed. Yes, Lord, destroy it completely. Listen, when you're praying to God, open your mouth and speak the word. You can't pray to God in your mind. You got to open your mouth and speak the word. So if you are speaking to God, please see that you open your mouth and speak the word. And if you are trying to speak it with your mind, you will get nothing. Because the Bible says you got to open your mouth and speak the word. Please open your mouth and speak the word. I see so many people's lips are tight. That's pride. That's a rebellious spirit. Come on, open your mouth and speak to him. Loving Father, as your people are speaking to you, I ask you, Holy Spirit, to direct their hearts, direct their minds, and let those words come out of their mouth, O Lord. Words of faith. Lord, destroy every negative word that they have ever spoken, every word that they have cursed somebody. They might have even cursed their own self in the midst of anger. Destroy all those words, O mighty God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, let your power, let your glory flow, touching their hearts, touching their lives, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for showing us that the words that I speak today of faith has the power to destroy the bondage, the walls, the plans of the devil. Lord, your word of faith has the power to bring great blessings and profits in my life. Thank you for teaching me the power of your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Praise God.